Good morning, class. How are you today? It's pleasant to hear that you're all doing great today. Now, before we feed ourselves into a new set of knowledge, may I request everyone to please stand up and feel the presence of the Lord. May I request Maribella to please lead us a short prayer. All right, before we take your seat, please pick up those scattered pieces of papers under your chairs and kindly arrange your chairs properly. Now, Miss Krisa, is there any absent today? All right, let's give ourselves a round of applause for we are all present today. All right, before you proceed, let us first have a quick recap on what was our topic last meeting. Now, what was our topic last meeting, class? Yes, Krisa. It is all about verbs. Very good. Now, what is all about verbs? Yes, Limuel. Verbs are action words. All right. Now, let's give examples of verbs. Yes, Marco. All right. Now, running. That is an example of verbs. Now, in what tense? In present progressive tense. All right. Let's have another example. Yes, Miss Marjorie walked. All right. That is an example of verb. And that is in past tense. Now, let's give ourselves a round of applause for we are able to recall our topic last meeting. All right. Now, let's be reminded on our class rules. And these are your LRT, meaning L for listen carefully and attentively, R for raising your hand or raise your right hand if you want to say something or if you want to be recognized, and letter T for take down notes if necessary. And whenever I say everybody eyes on me, you say eyes on you. I repeat, everybody eyes on me, you say eyes on you. Now let's try. Everybody eyes on me, eyes on you. All right. Now let's have a game called Think, Pair, Share. Now this activity, all you have to do is to listen carefully with my instructions. All right. Now you will be interviewing your classmate and your partner will be your seatmate, of course. Now ask them whatever information you want to ask them, whether their age, their hometown, their birthplace, their father's or mother's name, grandparents' name, their hobbies, or whatsoever under the sun. But of course, with limitations. Please don't ask questions below the belt, all right? Am I clear, class? All right, very good. Now, I will give you 3 minutes to do that activity. 2 minutes to ask or interview your partner and 1 minute to present your output here in class. Now, in order for us to know what or who will be presenting their outputs, I will pick 5 lucky pairs to present their outputs here in our classroom. All right. Now, I have here popsicle flags and you will write your names on this popsicle flags that I will provide. All right. Now, is everybody settled? All right. Let's start. All right, class. Time's up. Now, the 5 lucky pairs that I'll be picking will be Maribella and Althea. Number 2 will be LJ and Jezreel. Number 3 will be Jasmine and Marjorie. Number 4 will be Hanley and Krisa. And the last one will be Limuel and Judilyn. Now, please present your output, class. All right. Now, let's give them a round of applause. Now, class, what did you observe on your recent activity? It is all about, yes, Limuel. Asking questions, all right, you have a point. Yes, asking specific information. All right. Very good, Marco. Now, our topic is all about making questions, specifically the 5 W's and 1 H. Now, before we proceed, let's first have an activity called Arrange and Define Me. I have here jumbled letters, and all you have to do is to arrange these jumbled letters, and later on, you will be defining it. All right, let's have 5 volunteers to be at the front and arrange your jumbled letters. And if there is no volunteers, let's pick here in this popsicle flat. All right, there's volunteers. Marjorie, Jasmine, all right. Jasrel, Hanely, and Grisa. All right, be at the front now and arrange and define those words that you have arranged. All right, let's give ourselves a round of applause for they are able to arrange their words. All right, Miss Grisa, what is the word that you arranged? All about, it is the word what. All right, now what is all about what? Now this, all right, this is used for asking specific information. All right, very good with that. Let's give Chris a round of applause. Now, how about who? Who answered that? Who arranged that? All right, it's Miss Jasmine. Who is arranged? Who is what? Who is used to ask the specific names of an individual? Very good. Now, let's have another what. Yes, Mr. Limwell. It is a word. Why? All right. What is the word why? It is used in asking the cause of a specific problem. Very good. Now, let's have another. Where? All right. Let's have Marjorie. What is the word where? All right. Where is used to ask specific location of an event or happening. All right, very good, Marjorie. And how? All right, let's have LJ. LJ, what is the word how? All right, how is used to ask specific information about what manner. All right, now let's have the last one, the when. All right, who answered that? Yes, Mr. Dexter. What is all about the word when? It is asking specific date or day of an event. All right, let's give ourselves a round of applause for we are able to arrange and define those jumbled letters here in the front. All right. Now, we are tackling the 5 W's and 1 H. The what, where, when, who, why, and how. All right. Now, these questions are usually formed with this formula. The WH or H question plus the auxiliary verb plus the what. Your subject plus your main verb. And another one, the WH or H question plus the modal verb plus your subject, and your last one is your main verb. For example, where are you going? Now, where is the WH word? R is your auxiliary verb, you is the subject, and going is your main verb. Now, going is in a present progressive term. Now, that is your main verb. All right. Now, let's have another example. Why can't she decide? Now, why is your WH word? Can't, meaning cannot, is your modal verb, key is your main or subject, and the side is your main verb. Now, the side is in present tense. All right. Now, those are some examples of creating WH questions. Now, let's have another activity. Now, there are grouping cards under your chairs. The who, what, where, when, why, and how. Now, all you have to do is to create questions, three maximum questions under your group. For example, the who group. Who are the who group? All right, you will only focus on creating who questions. What group? All right, what will be focusing on creating questions of what, and so on and so forth. I will give you 8 minutes to do that activity, 5 minutes to craft, create your questions, and later on, I will give you 3 minutes to present your output. Now, our timer starts now. All right, time's up. Let's have your presentation. All right, let's give ourselves a round of applause, for we are able to create our questions. All right, now class, let's have another group activity. Now this activity is called Letter Ask Me. All right, this activity, all you have to do is, with the same group, you will create another set of questions, with, of course, basing on the literary piece that you will be picking on this envelopes that I will provide. All right, may I request volunteers? I mean, may I request representatives per group to please pick their literary pieces with this envelope. All right, now, before you open your envelopes, you will be creating questions as many as you can. Now, those questions will be scored with this rubric. All right, now, I will give you 10 minutes to do that activity. 7 minutes to create or formulate questions as many as you can, and 3 minutes to present your output. Now, your timer starts now. All right, your time is up. Let's have your presentation. May I request what group to please present their output? All right, let's give ourselves a round of applause for your presentation. Now, let me ask you a question. A few questions, rather. What are your WH questions again? The what, who, where, when, why, and how. Now, what is what? Used for asking specific information. All right. What is who? Who is used to create or ask questions about? All right. About asking specific names of an individual. All right. Very good. Now, what is where? Now, where is used to ask questions about specific location? Very good, class. Let's have another. The when. When is used to ask questions about specific day or dates of an event or happening. All right, very good, class. And why. Why is used to what? All right, very good, Limmel. Why is used to create questions or ask questions specific causes of an event or problem. All right, very good. And the last one, how. Yes, Jasmine. It is used to ask questions or create questions to ask what specific manner. All right, very good. Now let's give ourselves a round of applause, for we are able to recall, or we are able to grasp the idea of creating questions. All right, let's have another question. What is the usual formula in creating WH question? There are two. The first one, all right, very good. That is Marjorie, WH question plus the modal verb plus the subject plus the main verb. Another one, yes, Krista. All right, the WH question, an auxiliary verb plus the main, no, all right, that is the subject and then the main verb. All right, very good, Krista. And all right, let's give ourselves a round of applause for we are able to grasp the idea of creating WH questions. All right, now let's have another activity. This will be your quiz. All right, now this activity, all you have to do is to fill in the blanks. What WH questions is more proper in every question? All right, am I clear, class? I will give you 5 minutes to do the activity. I will provide answer sheets, of course. Please provide your name, grade, and section. All right. Starts now. All right, time's up. May I request your papers to please pass it now? All right, very good. Now, for your assignment, you will interview officials and present it to the class. I will be providing these instructions and rubrics for your activity. And for your advanced assignment, you will be reading about the Rodora, the poem Rodora by Ralph Waldo Emerson. And please be guided with the questions that I will be flashing. Alright, let's have a big round of applause for ourselves. Alright, now, I hope you learned something for me today. I hope you learned something with me today, class. I hope your knowledge will have been broadened, and I hope you enjoyed our lesson. Alright, that's it for today, class. Goodbye and see you tomorrow. Goodbye, class.